Baseball is live and on the air on the show. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the Durham Bulls and the Gwinnett Stripers. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Nolan Kingham will be on the mound for the series opener. What's your take on him, Dan?
One of the things that jumps out, if you look at that stat sheet, a very high whip coming into this start. One of the things he's going to have to do a much better job, keep traffic off the bases, keep the walks down, try to...
Next to hit is number 66, hitting at an even 220 on the year.
Rip it up.
First pitch on the way. Back up the middle, reined in.
Go hard.
But a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. Ow. Next, it'll be Jeffrey Ramos. First chance for him in this one. He's got that average pushing up near 350 to begin play.
This guy's having a really good year for his age, but this is something we've seen a lot lately. Young players coming up and impacting the lineup.
Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. One hit's all they get. Now to the plate, number 66. 0-1 for him here in this one.
Come on, big guy. See it. Drive it right here.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Martinez aboard here at first with nobody out. Nope. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there.
Well, that sinker is normally a really important pitch for him, but it really hasn't been effective so far. It just looks kind of flat.
Hey, get a good one. Get a good piece on it, huh? Let's go.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
That's a ball.
And this one just misses off
two
the
balls,
corner.
One strike.
Two and two the count.
Let it rip right here.
From the belt, the pitch. Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full. 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Count remains full.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Hey, you can do it. No one better. Start it up.
Count still full, 3-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Good swing just a little early, and he'll see another payoff pitch.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put-away stuff.
Let's go, kid. One time right here.
And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Garrett Moran grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll two.
It's through for a base hit, and he's 1-for-2 now.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
Now to the plate, here is number 66, and there are runners at the corners now.
Hey, have a rip.
From the stretch.
Ball one, no strike.
Hey, a curveball that kind of backed up on him right there. Might have popped out of his hand just a little bit earlier than he intended.
Lifted in the air to straightaway center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning.
He's out. He's
so now to the plate, number 66. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Off the plate, ball one.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
The 1-0 home. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right.
Find the ball. Make the turn.
But he can't get there as it falls. The relay. And now confusion here with two men on the same base. One's got to go, and they're going to get an out here. Next to dig in, Drew Lugbauer struck out in his last trip to the plate. Hit on the ground to short. Scooped up. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first. Striding in is Jalen Miller trying here to plate the tying run from second.
One down, one down. Come on, fellas, let's go.
From the belt, the pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. One there.
He's out.
Back to first. A double play. And they will strand the possible time run at second. This ball game is over. And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. The Durham Bulls jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Stetson Alley wins out of the bullpen his ninth victory of the year. Nolan Kingham worked only three innings in the losing effort. Oliver Drake hammers down the save, his 32nd of the season. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesak, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshow.com.
For Gwinnett, three runs, 11 hits, one error. They left 21 men on base.
Future stars are on display as minor league baseball comes your way on the show. Tonight, the second of three to start the week between the Durham Bulls and the Gwinnett Stripers. We've got baseball on the show. It's coming up next.
Stripers!
Kyle Muller is on the mound for game two. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, you can't always judge a pitcher by the numbers. I know the ERA is into the fours coming into this start, but he's actually a pretty solid pitcher. And every once in a while, he could throw some decent games in there.
Next to stand in is number 66. Not the shiniest of batting average as he comes in hitting down in the 220s for the year. First offering.
Ball. Down.
Guys, we take a look at the home nine as they take the field tonight. They've been mired in a team-wide slump of late, as with the loss last time out, they've now dropped eight of their last nine decisions.
Yeah, Matty V, and you know what, D-Row, this is when you really get tested. They call it the dog days of August for a reason. When you're struggling like this team is right now, the games get long, the schedule gets long, and you start looking forward towards the end of the season.
Yeah, but you got to find a way, Dan. You know as well as I do. You got to look in the mirror. You're playing for way more, especially the way this team is underachieved. You got to keep grinding. You got to find a way, put your foot on the gas, and show up to the yard every day ready to go.
2-1 now. The set and the 2-1. Slider, and it's off his glove, and it bounces away. So now two men in scoring position. Gigliotti at third. Henderson on a second with two down. Hit the other way out toward right field. Harris is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. So they get a couple of men into scoring position. Into the box, Aure Adrianza, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second.
Aure Adrianza.
A bouncer up the middle. This is going to scoot on through into center for a base hit leading off the inning.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Set the...
One out, runner at first. And up to bat next is Shea Langeliers.
Shea Langeliers.
Hit on the ground out to short. Oh, and he can't come up with it.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there.
Stepping in once again is number 66. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Now here's the first offering. Right on that pitch that time as he wraps it into center field.
Find the ball,
base hit.
Find the ball, find the ball.
Next, it'll be Jim Haley. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Third inning, no score to this point. Bouncer to the left side. Up with it there is Sandoval. And the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. So it's no runs on two hits. No. Digging in next, Pablo Sandoval. He bounced out last time up.
Pablo Sandoval.
Swinging is Sandoval as he sends this one on the ground to shortstop. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag. So now into the box is number 66. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
One time right here.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
Hey. All one's the count.
So important getting ahead with the bases loaded. Already a difficult situation, so you don't want to make it any harder by falling behind in the count.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And this is going to play at least two of those runners as it's down for extra bases. One run is scored. Throw won't get him.
Yeah, he squares this thing up beautifully and blasts it through the gap all the way to the wall. Then the only question that remained was whether two or three runs were going to score. They held the runner at third, but that's a timely two-run double.
So the next to bat will be Jim Haley, one for two. He's singled and grounded out so far.
Haley.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he goes down and gets this one as it's lifted high into the air out to medium deep center. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third.
Come on, come on,
the
get down, get down.
The tag at third, and they got him. A double play. And very quickly here, the side is retired. So three runs on only two hits in the inning. No errors. Now at the plate, here is number 66. Two for three with a double on his line so far. First pitch on its way. And this is taken outside for ball one.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
2-0 now. Bases are empty, one man out. Down the third baseline, and that's through for a hit.
I appreciate the moxie right there, but three fastballs at this level usually turns into a knock.
Next to hit, Jim Haley. He was a double play victim last time around.
Jim Haley.
Wait for your pitch up
there. And he'll get back in safely. Runners on first with one down. And now they've got him in a rundown. And a good decision to throw as he is toast at second base.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game.
Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
This evening's game comes to an end 5-4, the final tally. The Stripers came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Connor Johnstone earns the victory out of the bullpen, his fifth. Baseball on the show for you now as we present coverage from the AAA East. Tonight, the rubber match of this three-game series between the Durham Bulls and the Gwinnett Stripers. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next.
The Stripers.
Tanner Tully, a lefty from Indiana, is on the mound here. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy comes into this start, Matt, having lost two of his last three starts, so you know he wants to get off on the right foot.
So here's the cleanup hitter, number 66, hitting 500 in the series so far, 4-for-8. He's set. Here it comes. Line drive to left. Ramos is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. Now with the plate is Jeffrey Ramos. And you see the numbers there. He's been very dangerous at the plate, to say the least. Bouncer to the left side. In time to first, and there are two away.
Three.
Now at the plate, number 66. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Pitch on the way. Down the line and fair, that's a hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Not really much the pitcher can do about that one. He put the ball down in the zone where he wanted it, but it was just a solid piece of hitting. Goes down and gets it and pulls it into the corner for extra bases.
Yeah, as you know, Dan, sometimes the hitter just wins.
The first base.
So next to hit is Jim Haley. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. He's set. Here's the 0-1. Hit to third. There's Sandoval. Throw in time at first for out number two. So stepping in is Taylor Walls, trying here to plate the tying run from second.
And one pitch.
Two and one, here it is. Hit on the ground to third.
Come on, get down, slide, slide.
Throw in time and the side is retired. But the damage is done as thanks to the solo home run, this is now a one.
He's safe.
Digging in will be number 66. One for two with a
number
double
66.
On his line thus far.
One time right here.
Here's the first pitch. Foul tip into the catcher's glove. It's strike one.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
And let it rip. Let it rip.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
We got two balls, one strike.
Come on, big guy. Keep driving. Keep driving.
Ball, that's just out.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or do you just pitch around them?
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
Here you go. Let it fly.
Hit out towards second. He's got it. The second
come
for
on,
one.
Come on,
on
come
to
on,
first
come
as
on.
They get the double play to get him out of the inning.
Like
digging in, the switch hitter, Garrett Moran. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. Three runs already home here. Sent on the ground out to second. Reined in. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So they pick up three runs on four base hits. No errors, and a couple of men left. Next will be the cleanup hitter, number 66. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point.
Butterfly right here.
And now the first pitch. Hit high and deep out to left field. Gone. He uses that short porch to an advantage. Home run. A solo shot here to left. Home run number two for him on the year. And it's a 7-2 game now.
Well, when it left its bat, I didn't think it had the height to even clear the fence. Shows you how much I know. That thing was a laser shot that just kept going. Well, this one had its moments of drama and excitement. In the end, these guys came away with the victory and look on to the next one.
And this evening's ends with a 7-2 finish. The Gwinnett Stripers jumped out to it.
Clean a base. Got a convoy if you got it. Ain't no stopping on the go. Got a convoy if you got it. Going live, good at the show. Got a convoy if you got it. Ain't no stopping on the go. Got a convoy if you got it. Going live, good at the show. Feel the pain. Step on the deck. We need to stretch. Moment of truth. Playing it cool. Wipe out the sweat. Get in the zone. King on the throne. I'm about to flex. Homer, I'm gone. And by their opponent, show me who next. Play in the field, look alive. Slide, die, line, drive like Dion on prime time. I'm 0 to NY, but now when I settle in, I break ground.